Making love in a zero-G environment may not produce the satisfaction we project. The proposed erotic possibilities deny Newton's laws of motion and how they will affect our romantic inclinations in space stations. Momentum changes in proportion to force acting on a resting body and making it move. And every action is opposed by an equal reaction of the same magnitude in the opposite direction, without exception. Now I may be wrong, but it seems to me, when contemplating the dynamics of sex, that trying to do it in zero G may present some pressing problems we did not expect. Making love in a zero-G environment may be more hazardous than advocates assume. Adrift in compartments three-dimensional, pelvic push may quickly find lovers parted and marooned or rebounding off the walls. A ricochet free fall. Zero-G may have industrial advantages for pharmaceuticals, ball bearings, and steel. But in matters of human sensuality, friction is essential. Future studies may reveal that weightless copulation induces frustration. Now I may be wrong, but it seems to me that carnal stimulation will be desired. So in order to do it in zero G, some new techniques may be required. Making love in a zero-G environment may foster changes in our moral attitudes. 'Cause nature provides for the planet bound, but the state of the art in orbit must improve. Desperate lovers may engage a space-age sex aids. Together tethers would prevent random wandering, magnetic harnesses incorporating alternating poles. Could sustain an interaction electrically. Rear thrusters would supply perfect docking control. Entry speed and rhythm set easy on the retro jets. Now I may be wrong, but it seems to me that we'll never be sure unless we go and try it. So for reasons of promoting space industry, we should encourage the idea the general public will buy it. Making love in a zero-G environment is a problem we must solve to survive. With a dash of erotic ingenuity and invention of necessity, science will arrive at a feasible solution to the 21st century sensual revolution.